Right now at noon, we're also busy in the tropics, tracking a tropical depression Eta as it rapidly redevelops over the warm Caribbean waters off the coast of Belize. We just learned Cuba is now under a tropical storm watch. And that storm is expected to slowly strengthen as it gets a little closer here to South Florida this weekend and could bring some tropical storm conditions our way.
In fact, a flood watch is now in effect as residents prepare for severe flooding with several inches of rain predicted for some areas. So we want to send it right on over to Brandon because, yeah, we got a lot to look out for this weekend.
Yeah, especially since we've already seen so much flooding in October. You know how much rain we've had. The ground is still saturated from that and really can't handle that much more water. So I think that's going to be the main threat. But here's the latest advisory. Maximum sustained winds at 35 miles per hour. That means it's still a tropical depression. There's the center of it. It's back out over water. But look at the size of this thing. It takes these larger systems a little bit longer to get themselves together and get them turning than it does a smaller system. So I wouldn't be surprised if this takes until later this afternoon or this evening to eventually reach tropical storm status again, eventually moving towards Cuba. This is as a 60 mile per hour tropical storm and then taking that sharp curve to the west. There's still some uncertainty as to where it takes that curve. Is it going to be closer to Key West in the Florida Straits, or is it going to be closer to Miami-Dade or somewhere in the middle? But either way, the effects from this storm will be felt farther out from the center than other storms that we're used to. So don't look at the exact center of this, but the intensity forecast from the Hurricane Center has this moving through as a 65 mile per hour tropical storm. That means we would likely get some gusts near the coast to hurricane force of 75 or so. This is what our model has in terms of rain as we get towards tonight and to tomorrow morning. More spotty showers, nothing too crazy here. But as we get towards the afternoon, this is when that flooding threat starts to develop on Saturday. You can see these rain bands coming in, these feeder bands coming around that system and all that moisture that's out ahead of it. This is going into Sunday afternoon. This is when the core of the system nears South Florida. In terms of rainfall, we're still expecting 6 to 10 inches, but I wouldn't be surprised if some places squeeze out some isolated higher amounts. That is very significant considering the rain that we've had so far in October. That's why we have a flood watch up and down the coast, and we also have some winds to worry about in terms of tropical storm conditions. Most of that will start being felt on Sunday and will last into Monday. We also have a tornado threat mainly on Sunday and Monday as well. In terms of right now, a few little showers coming in off the coast. It's not all that much today. Lots of dry time in between those showers. Christy, I'll be back with you here in just a little bit. I want to go day by day, take a closer look at the timeline of the storm as it moves through. That's ahead.